the Mormon Church has done and what high demand religions do is they try to demonize certain emotions. They tell you that anger is bad. They tell you that if you're feeling sad, you're doing something wrong. They tell you that if you're angry, well, that's of the adversary. That's Satan. That's the devil. Or if you get a feeling of fear, well, that means that you should stay away from something that you're exposed to. And this, whether it's intentional or not, is a very manipulative technique. Because sometimes, let's just say that you stumble on some information about the Mormon Church that you didn't know before. Yeah, it's going to be scary. You're going to feel afraid because you've been conditioned to view the world this way. And all of a sudden, you're contemplating new information that might change your worldview. And of course, humans have evolved to feel fear whenever a big change might take place. But that doesn't mean that that fear is of the devil. And that doesn't mean you shouldn't continue on and learn. Just like you come out of the mother's womb, you may feel afraid. Should you go back in the mother's womb? No, you endure that fear and you keep learning and growing. Well, anger is the same type of thing. When we feel anger, it's usually because we're either sad or afraid. So there's the primary emotion of sadness or fear. And then anger is an emotion, a secondary emotion that we've evolved to have that gives us power. And so let me just tell you how it works. If you feel afraid, or if you feel scared, if you feel scared or sad, then that might be because you learned that your church wasn't what you thought it was. It may be because you learned that your leaders were deceiving you. It may be because you realized that you built your whole life on something that wasn't true. Well, anger emerges to do several things. It helps focus your attention. It helps get you to pay attention and to learn lessons so that you won't ever be fooled again. Anger gives you power, and it gives you the energy and the strength to make important decisions that may be difficult. Maybe you need to learn more. Maybe you need to change your beliefs. Maybe you need to change your relationships with others or with an organization. Anger can sometimes give you the power and the strength to make difficult choices. And it can communicate to people who have harmed you that you don't ever want to be harmed again. But if the church teaches you that anger is bad and evil and of the devil, they're keeping you weak, they're keeping you submissive, and they're keeping you subdued in a place where they can continue to exert undue influence on you.